Hi, I'm former Buckeye quarterback Rex Kern. I played football, basketball, and baseball in high school. Those experiences provided me with learning opportunities not necessarily found in the classroom. High school sports help young people learn about hard work, discipline, and sacrifice, and they go a long way in helping provide the tools needed to succeed in life. High school sports are more than extracurricular. They're extra important, too.
This message presented by the Ohio High School Athletic Association.
From Millersport High School, it's a beautiful night. Football high gainer Jack Davis along with Caleb Young and the rest of the FCA media team tonight. It's the 1-7 FCA Knights, coached by B.J. Queen, taking on Millersport. The Lakers at 6-2 under head coach Terry Holbert. After suffering a 48-game losing streak, Millersport is 6-2 this year. In the conference, they are 3-2, and they stand 10th overall in the computer points for a playoff spot. The first eight go to the playoffs. Millersport won the toss. They've elected to receive. They are in the home purple with the white numerals, the gold pants, and the pink socks in honor of Breast Cancer Awareness. FCA and the traveling whites with the red numerals trim, helmets, and pants. Welcome, Caleb. Who are the officials for tonight?
Well, Jack, the referee is Terry Owens. The umpire is Charlie McDill. The linesman, Todd Hollett. The line judge, Joshua Cooper. And the back judge, Gary Falloon.
Fairfield Christian Academy students are broadcasting.
This is the FCA Sports Network. You can watch this game on LSN TV, Lancaster Time Warner Channel 9, or on YouTube at LancasterOhio.tv.
Also, we'll be on YouTube at Lancaster Ohio TV in just a few hours. Be sure to check this game out.
Jacob Nares will tee it up for FCA. Caleb Laubenthal
like
will be a quarterback tonight
to
as Bobby Leeper is out for tonight's ball game. Probably see Jeremiah Lee getting some handoffs along with Caleb Walls. So FCA will begin this game kicking off. They are presently 6th in the conference behind the 5-0 Harvest Prep Warriors. Harvest Prep comes in tonight with a record of 5-0. Grove City Christian
Jake
is 3-1.
Is back to kick for
Millersport
the
at 3-2. Fisher Number Catholic four, at 2-2. Burn Union FCA at 1-3. And Worthington Christian at 0-4. 63 degrees at kickoff. And we're underway at Millersport. And just like that, Dalton Ankeny has a great kickoff return for Millersport to put them in great field position to begin this football game.
Well, nice job by Isaac Payne forcing him out of bounds. He was the last defender.
Lakers will start out first and 10 from the Knights
29. Jonah Butts is the quarterback, number 13.
Brandon Konenbitter has had a really good year so far.
Absolutely.
So we're
He'll be the one to look at, look
yeah.
for, isn't it? Pitch goes to Clayton Moore, for a short game. Town of Millersport is excited about this football team, and why shouldn't they be?
Gain of 3 on that play brings up 2nd and 7 for Millersport.
2nd and 7. That's Kronenbitter on the carry.
Number 2, Brandon Kronenbitter, the ball carrier for the Lakers.
Bring up 3rd and
pick up the 4 on the play. Brings up 3rd and 4 for Millersport.
Mark the ball at the 22-yard line. This is senior night at Millersport. Cronenbitter has it around right end. He'll dive
number
for
two,
the first
Brandon
down.
Cronenbitter, the ball carrier. Tackle made by number 83, Isaac Payne.
And they're going to have a timeout, maybe to measure.
Yardage is good for a Millersport.
They're
going to
move the chains, and it's first down for Millersport.
First and 10 Lakers from the Knights 19.
Butts over center. Bo Thorne gets the ball. Over the 15 to the 14-yard line.
Number 25, Bo Thorne, the ball carrier. Pick up the four on the play, brings up second and six for the Lakers.
Second and six inside the 15. I'll mark it at the 14. Thorne and Cronenbitter in the backfield. Butts the quarterback. Give to Cronenbitter. Hit and dropped.
Excellent tackle by Logan Rocha that time, getting some
number
penetration.
Two, Cronenbitter, the ball carrier. Stop made by number 12.
And
Logan
that's what
Rocha.
The Knights are going to need tonight, or for the older players to step up.
Loss of 2 yards.
Yes, they are, because Cronenbitter is not that big. He's small and fast, so.
He is one of their leading, in fact, he is their leading ball carrier. He has close to 700 yards coming into this football game. Butts throws left side to Clayton Moore. 10, 5, end zone. Touchdown, Millersport.
That pass is completed to number 4, Clayton Moore, taking it for a Millersport touchdown.
It's a 16-yard touchdown pass.
Makes the score Lakers 6.
Puts Millersport
zero.
Up 6-0 with the point after up. To follow. Bo Thorne will be doing the kicking honors here. Tee it up at the 10. And Clayton Moore will hold. High snap, ball down. Kick is up, and it is blocked. Timeout on the field with 8:58 to go here in the first quarter. Millersport takes an early 6-0 lead on the FCA Knights here on the FCA Sports Network.
The FCA Sports Network was brought to you by Big Sandy Superstore. They were founded in 1953, and they believe in giving customers the best possible value for their money spent. And if there is a problem, they simply follow the golden rule. This simple formula has stood the test of time. Big Sandy Superstore, bigger, better, in Lancaster on Memorial Drive. Online at BigSandySuperstore.com.
So FCA will get the ball to for the first time here. The start of this fourth quarter, we're a little under,
so,
little over 3 minutes.
If so, we hope that you will come
in.
Out and support our school on November 4th. Make sure you get out
back
and be an
for the Knights will be
on November 4th.
Caleb Walds, Jeremiah Lee. Troy McClung is the kicker. Tees it up. Line drive kick. It'll hit inside the 25. Lee has it at the 20. Looks for a seam. 25 up to about the 30-yard line. The Knights will take it over first down. Caleb Lobenthal will be quarterback tonight. Jeremiah Lee. And Caleb Waltz will be your major running back
tonight.
Number
57, Chase Hatfield, is going to be first and 10 for
Hatfield
the Knights.
Hatfield on the stop. So the Knights'
from
first possession.
29.
At the 29. Payne in motion. Give to Caleb Walls. It's the 30. And driven back. We'll mark it at the 31. It will be second and 8. It's a familiar field for the FCA seniors because this
brings
is the
second and eight
this used to be the home
Academy.
Field for the FCA Knights a few years ago until they moved out to New Lex. We'll be at New Lex next week for the final home game of the seniors, season senior night. There's Jeremiah Lee coming off right end. Might have gained a yard, bring up third and long.
Third and seven, six and a half, seven. Third and seven.
Pick up of a yard on that play. Brings up third and seven.
Got official
for the
timeout.
Knights. Official's timeout looks like equipment.
Equipment issue. Jonah Butts coming out. Third and a long seven for the Knights. Ball is almost caught, and then nearly intercepted. As a Kane intended receiver.
At
the 39, if he would have caught it, it'd been enough for the first down, and that's the fourth down now for the Knights. And they'll bring out Colin Blackwell, who kicked the ball away, to Clayton Moore. Moore will stand at his 40-yard line. Blackwell will have his heels at the 17. Low snap, wobbly kick, it'll hit at the 45, take an FCA bounce inside the 40 to the 38-yard line. They'll bring up first down for the Knights with 8:03 to go in the first quarter of play. Knights
that
down 6-0
to the Lakers
Port.
38. It's going to be first and 10 Lakers from their own 38.
Jonah Butts gets the play from the sidelines, and he's ready to go. Thorne to his right. Cronenbitter behind him. Pitch to Cronenbitter. Hits the 35. And driven out of bounds.
Pitch goes to number two, Brandon Cronenbitter.
It's Jeremiah Lee on the stop, and we got a penalty flag on the play.
There's a late flag after the play.
Might be on the Knights for a late hit. Or for hitting him, driving him out of bounds. That's a sideline warning on Millersport. Okay.
Well, that was sort of unexpected.
Looks like a sideline warning against the Lakers.
So Millersport, they'll huddle up at the 20 and they'll have to sprint to about the 40 to line up at the line of scrimmage.
10 Lakers from their own 38.
All right, second down and 10. No gain on the play. Butts back to pass, looks, throws long. He's got Moore open, caught. And he steps out of bounds at the 25-yard line.
That pass is completed to number four, Clayton Moore.
Pretty pass by Jonah Butts to Clayton
steps
Moore.
Steps out of bounds at the Knights 35. But that yardage is good for a Laker first down.
Where Millersport moves the chains.
First and 10 Lakers from the Knights 25.
I'll mark it at the 25, the right hash. This Millersport team's pretty impressive. We were anxious to see what they look like this year.
Yeah, their offense has looked pretty good
so
far.
Their offense has looked outstanding. Able to get the ball to Moore on the wing, or Cronenbitter to sweep the end. There's Butts looking to pass, throws long. He's got Moore, incomplete. Nice deflection there on the coverage.
Isaac Nayer is
on
the coverage that time.
Clayton Moore.
This is his first game playing defense. Usually he's just offensive player.
He looked good on that pass coverage.
His excellent coverage.
Second 10 for the Lakers.
Absolutely. Moore ran a little little post pattern there. Came open at the last minute, but Nair stuck his hand out to deflect the pass. Bring up second 10 at the 25. Butts to Bo Thorne up the gut. Met by a horde of Knights. Blackwell is there, along with Isaac Payne.
Number 25, Bo Thorne, the Laker ball carrier.
Miles Ralph there as
Pick
well.
Pick up two on that play. Brings up third and eight for Millersport.
So third and eight. This looks like it'll be four down territory for Millersport if they fail to get the third down.
Well, we'll see if the Knights defense will hold. They've looked pretty good so far.
Give to Moore. And he's brought down. Fourth and we'll say five. Colin Blackwell
number
there on the
Clayton
stop.
Moore, the Laker ball carrier.
Along with Miles Ralph.
Pickup of two on that play brings up fourth and six for the Lakers.
So fourth and six for the Lakers at the 21-yard line. So Butts, back to pass. Looks, rolls, throws, long it is. Intercepted by the Knights. Intercepted by Logan Rocha.
Well, sort of dumb intercepting that ball. They would have had it with better field position if he hadn't have done it.
Yes, they would have.
Oh, well,
that's a,
some people just go for the
turnover, but
and 10 Knights from their own six.
Logan probably just looked at that as an interception and was hoping to have a return. So good coverage by Logan Rocha. Now the Knights get the ball on the pass interception turnover. First and 10 at the 6. Caleb Walls working on the outside. Across the 10 to maybe the 11-yard line. Gain of 5. Good gain of first down.
Number 32,
bring up second
Caleb
and 5.
On that Knights carry. Pick up a 5 on that play.
Now, Caleb, we have been really blessed with the weather this year for football. This is just such a comfortable night. We're talking in the past how we're a little bit leery getting into the end of the football season, the end of October, how it can get cold and chilly. But this is just a very comfortable, delightful night.
We've gotten really lucky this year.
And the weather report, at least for 5 days going into next week, looks like to be in the 70s. So enjoy it while we can. We really haven't had much of an Indian summer. That might be the Indian summer coming up. Caleb Walls off right guard. Gains a couple. Going to bring up third and short. Looks like third and a long 4 yards to go.
Number 32, Caleb Walls carries for the Knights.
Mark it at the
pickup of two on that play.
13.
Brings up third and two for him.
So the second possession for the Knights. Let's see if they can get the first down. Lobenthal over center. Caleb Walls across the 15, 16, maybe the 17-yard line. Will be close to a first down.
Well, he pushed forward a little bit at the end, and they're going to move the chains.
They're moving the chains, so the Knights got a first down out of this possession, and they're starting to get their sea legs, so to speak.
First down, Knights.
Get some continuity on the offensive side of the football. Knights break the huddle, 4:44 to go, first quarter of play.
16.
Millersport up 6-0. Jeremiah Lee cuts up close to the 20-yard line, across the 20, maybe the 21.
Number 4, Jeremiah Lee, the ball carrier.
Gain of 4, it'll be 2nd and 6.
Now that time, they're moving their front around pretty good.
Caleb Walls alone back in the backfield. Wing backs, Jeremiah Lee now in motion. Give to Caleb. He's got a lane. 30, 32-yard line. First down for the Knights. Flag on the play. We'll see. That's holding on the Knights. So
number 32,
bring it
Caleb
back.
Balls on the carry. There's a flag behind the play. Holding the call against the Knights.
I'll back him up 10 from the spot of the foul. It'll be 2nd down again.
It'll be a 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul.
And let's see where they're going to mark the ball. They're marking it at the 10-yard line. Knights have had some nice lanes to run in the past couple plays. There's Nairs scooting to the outside. Nice gain by Isaac across the 20 to 21. So he gets the penalty yardage back, and it'll bring up third down. And we'll say about five.
Number seven, Isaac Nayer, is the ball carrier for the Knights.
Isaac looked good on that run. Just kind of waited for his blockers. And
yeah, he did.
Brings up third and
pretty
six.
Pretty impressive.
Third and five. Maybe a long five, maybe six. Nares gets it again. Round left end. 25 to the 28, maybe the 29. It's going to be close to a first down.
Number seven, Isaac Nayers on that carry for the Knights.
And they're going to give it to him.
Pulled out of bounds by number nine, Tyler McClung.
McClung on the tackle. The Knights move the chains. So they recover from that penalty. And they are first and 10 now at the 29. Caleb Walls up the gut, 35, 37 yard line.
Caleb Walls didn't want to be outdone.
Number 32, Caleb Walls, the ball carrier.
Caleb hits that ball hard.
Stop made by number four, Clayton Moore.
Clayton Moore on the
and
stop.
And assisted by number 73, Nathan Sandusky.
And Nathan Sandusky on the
play.
Stop.
Brings up second and two for the Knights.
Second and two with 2:55 to go here in the first quarter of play. That's first down yardage for the Knights. As Caleb Walls will move the chains. Good looking drive for the Knights. They start at their own six.
Yardage picked up for a first down there for Fairfield Christian and Academy.
Well, the Knights are taking time off the
first
clock
and
running the ball pretty effectively.
Yes, they are. You think they may want to just pound the football tonight. There's a, it's like a busted play.
Robenthal sacked in the backfield.
Kept the ball.
Sack made lost by number 25,
loss of
Bill
five.
Thorne.
Maybe six. That'll
bring loss
up
of
second
six on
along.
That play. Brings up second and 16 for the Knights.
You think that the Knights would just kind of want to pound the football tonight, seeing as Bobby Leeper is out and Caleb Robenthal, he's a good quarterback, doesn't have necessarily the experience to throw the ball. Jeremiah Lee on the carry.
Number 37. Jeremiah Lee, the Knights ball carrier. Stop made
and
by number 25, Bo Thorne.
Third and long. Bo Thorne on the stop.
Pickup of two on that play brings up third and 14
third
for the Knights.
Third and 14 for the Knights. Eighty seconds to go here in the first quarter. Robenthal under center. Back to pass. Rushed, throws. Incomplete. Isaac Payne, his intended receiver. He had Logan Roca open at the 40.
Isaac Payne.
Wide open.
Brings up fourth and 14
but
for the Knights.
Pass rush rushed Caleb. Went to a secondary receiver, Isaac Payne. And that'll bring up a fourth down. 57.4 seconds to go. Colin Blackwell is back to punt. 6-0 Millersport. 57.4 seconds to go. Good snap. Wobbly kick that'll hit the 30.
Ooh, really good.
Inside the 30 to about the 25-yard line.
Knights punt the ball away. Rolled out of bounds at the Lakers 25. Going to be first and
first
10 Millersport
and 10
from
for
their
Millersport
25.
Now. Their third possession of the ball game. They scored on their first possession. And a butts to Moore pass play.
And they almost scored in the second if he hadn't have stepped out of bounds.
And Logan Roca came up with the pick on that to stop Millersport in the track. So now it'll be first and 10 at their own 25. Butts will keep it. We'll get back to the line of scrimmage. Bring up second down. Knights defense snuffed that out.
No gain on that Lakers run. Brings up second and 10 for Millersport.
Go, 75%
off. 30 seconds to go.
Four's on the field. 4, 9, 3. Two's
at tailback. Bo Thorne to the left of Butts, gives to Cronin Bitter. Heads to the outside, looks for a hole, has a lane, and he runs out of bounds close to a first
number
down.
Number 2, Brandon Cronenbitter, the Laker ball carrier.
I didn't think he had anywhere to go, but he found a lane and used his speed to get by some defenders.
Runs out of bounds, be third down, and see, they'll mark it at the 30.
Gain a 7 on that play, brings
two,
up third,
so
it'll
be
three
third
for
and three. 9.7 seconds to go. Barring a penalty, this will be the last play of the quarter.
Trips, we need to watch spot, watch spot.
Three wide receivers to the right. Pitch to Cronenbitter. Finds a lane, hits the 40 to the 44. First down from Millersport, and that's
Brandon
the 1.9 seconds to go.
Stop made by number 14,
they'll move the chains.
But not Bull for a Laker. First down.
And that should do it. One quarter in the books. Millersport leads FCA 6-0 on the FCA Sports
Network. That concludes the first quarter. Your Lakers lead at 6, Knights 0.
In 1929, in Chicago, a gentleman by the name of Marion Wade, former minor league baseball player, started the company. It was just a moth-proofing company then. In 1952, it expanded to carpet cleaning and pioneered what is now called outsourcing. And the Sidwells wanted a community that had a lot of churches, had a lot of soccer opportunities, where kids love soccer, and a good parks and rec department, so they chose Lancaster. And so in 1980, they moved the franchise here in Lancaster, to 6th Avenue. But then in 2002, Todd George, current owner, purchased the franchise from them. And in 2004, he bought a building that's on Mulberry Street, and that's where the franchise is located currently. I'm Jay Johnson, General Manager of Service Master Clean by Todd George, where we guarantee if it's not done right the first time, we'll do it again.
Service Master Clean by Todd George, 740-687-1077. 740-687-1077.
Jack Davison and Caleb Yon around the, along with the FCA media team on the FCA Sports Network. First and 10 for Millersport. It leads 6-0. Start of the second quarter. Pitch to the outside, intended for Moore, goes incomplete.
Butts pass intended for number 4, Clayton Moore.
Bring up second
incomplete.
And 10.
Brings up second and 10.
The blockers out there for a nice gain if they would have completed that pass.
Yeah, they were looking for the screen, but he threw it a bit ahead of Moore and wasn't able to make the completion.
Millersport, after seeing them, I've seen them play for a number of years because they've played against FCA. This is certainly the best team they've had in a number of years, but they look more confident, quicker. They're making decisions right at the snap of the ball, good decisions, and there's a loss on the play. They're getting the ball out to their playmakers, such as Cronenbitter, out in open space, or Clayton Moore, and they're able to do something with it. Not there. The Knights snuff that one out, so it'll bring up third and 10 at the 44.
On third and long from this field position.
Butts the quarterback. Back to pass. Looks, throws long. He's got a receiver. It's Moore. It is
caught.
This is completed to number 3, Storm Singleton.
That's Singleton.
First down.
Singleton on the reception.
Butts to Singleton.
I thought that would have been an interception for the Knights.
It almost looked like it was.
Like Singleton just pulled the ball away. Good play by Singleton. Storm Singleton. It's wide to the left. Moore in the slot to his right. Bo Thorne gets the carry. And he'll be close to a first down.
Number 25, Bo Thorne up the middle. Tackle made by number 4, Jeremiah Lee.
Lee on the stop, and let's see, that's going to be a, officials are looking at it, and they're going to say it's a first down.
Gain of 10 on that play results in a Laker first down. First and 10 Lakers from the Knights 21.
Ball on the 21, butts under center, gives the Thorn. Across the 20 to about the 16-yard line.
Number 25, Bo Thorne, the Lakers.
Gain of 4 will be 2nd and 6.
Gain of 4 on that play brings up 2nd and 6 for the Lakers.
Quickly played first quarter. This is a quickly played first half here. Already almost 2 minutes into the second quarter.
Well, with that run, Thorne has tied Cronenbitter with 19 yards.
Singleton and Moore split out wide to the right. It's at the top of the screen. Butts will keep it. Spins across the 15 to the 14-yard line. Isaac
number 13,
Payne.
Jonah Butts calls his own number on that carry.
Stop. Isaac had good penetration there.
Pick up a 3 on that play. Brings up 3rd and 3 for
and
the Lakers.
3rd and 3 for Millersport. Last time they were down here, the Knights held with an interception. It's 4 down territory. This might be 4 down territory here with 9.5 to go in the first half. Stay tuned at halftime. We'll have the Millersport Lakers band on for the halftime entertainment. Thorne should have enough for a first down.
Handoff goes to number 25, Bo Thorne.
Timeout on the field as the officials will look at the spot of the football and move the chains.
Laker first down.
Ball just the outside of the 10-yard line,
first
so they should be able to get a first down inside the one. Singleton and Moore out wide to the right. Thorne and Cronenbitter in the backfield. Moore in motion to the left. Cronenbitter gets the carry. Hits the 10 to the 9.
Number 2, Brandon Cronenbitter, the Laker ball carrier.
Like Miles Ralph was on that stop.
Picked up a yard on that play. Brings up 2nd and 9
second
for
and
the Lakers
9.
From the 10.
Well, Miles Ralph did a nice job. He read the play and got in there to make the stop. Nice tackle also.
Three wide receivers to the right. Thorne is in the slot. Pitch to Cronenbitter. He's going to reverse direction. He's going to scoot to the 10 and brought down at about the 8-yard line, maybe 7. Isaac Nairs held his ground well. They'll bring up 3rd down.
Stop
nice play by Isaac.
7, Isaac Nairs. Pick up a 3 on that play. Brings up 3rd and 6 for Millersport.
So 3rd and a long 6.
Cronenbitter is dangerous when he changes directions like that time because some defenses can't chase him down, but Nairs was over there luckily and saved the touchdown.
Butts throws right side, caught by Moore. He's going to scoot. Now he's going to try to gain some yardage, and he's going to lose yardage as he got greedy trying to make a play.
Catches that.
And the Knights snuffed that play out, and
it's
a loss of about 8. And it'll bring up 4th, and we'll say
brings up 4th and 14 for the Lakers.
13 to go. Ball's at the 14. They have to get to the 1-yard line for a first down. Now we got 3 wide receivers to the right, 1 to the left. Butts back to pass, looks, throws, end zone, incomplete. The Knights hold again. Good defensive stand by the Knights as they take over on their own 14. The only problem is they'd like to have better field position, but you know, when you hold, right?
Yep.
Knights have not had good field position tonight.
No, they haven't. Well, going back to that one play with Moore on that screen. On a screen, you can't really hesitate like he did. He looked for the running lane. That was a loss of them.
Yeah, Millersport, their lone touchdown tonight is because they had that nice kickoff return. They started at the Knights 25. Gain of close to four there.
Number 32, Caleb
by
Harris,
Caleb Walls, and they'll bring up second and six.
Pick up a four on that play, brings up second and six for Fairfield Christian.
You know, usually when we've played Millersport, it's been early in the season, and off to our left we'd be able to see the Sweet Corn Festival with the rides and be able to smell the cooking, but tonight it's a little later in the season. Caleb Walls on the carry.
Number 32, Caleb Walls.
Host of Lakers on the stop. Gain of maybe one will bring up third and five.
Stop made by a boatload of Lakers.
Dalton Ankeny was a bit slow getting up on that play.
Looks
like he's holding his arm a little bit.
It's one thing that the Lakers have is speed. They've always been great in track. They're a particularly fast team this year, and they're really flying to the ball. Lobenthal throws right side. It is incomplete. Tended receiver.
That pass falls incomplete.
Was Logan Roca.
By number nine, Tyler McClung.
Tyler McClung
five for the
got a hand on it. And that'll bring up fourth down for the Knights. Colin Blackwell will kick the ball away. He'll stand at his five. Clayton Moore will stand at the Knights' 43-yard line. Christian.
Number four, Clayton Moore back to return.
Now Moore backs up to the 45. No wind to speak of. High snap. Booming kick. Moore will field it at the 50, and his knees touched at the 50. So Millersport will get the ball
receives that punt at midfield. It's going to be first and 10. Lakers from the 50.
5:15 to go here in the first half. And this is where we're talking about field position. The Millersport has not had to go the length of the field.
No, they haven't.
Now they're working with a short field again. Knights would like to be able to turn that around and work with a short field. First and 10 now.
Well, we've seen where they can make this up with just one simple pass play.
Yes, they are explosive. Singleton in motion. Moore spins. He'll gain a couple.
Number four, Clayton Moore, the Laker ball carrier. Gain of 2 yards on that play.
Be second and eight for Millersport. The Knights 48-yard line.
He would have been stopped for no gain if it wasn't for that spin move he pulled and juked out just about three guys.
See, in past years, Millersport wouldn't do that. They would not do a spin move. Their playmakers have improved greatly. There's Thorne who's able to make a cut there, and it's across the 45, about the 43-yard line.
Well, Thorne's been excellent so far.
Number 25, Bo Thorne, the ball carrier.
In past years, Millersport would follow the play, and when the play would die, they wouldn't try to get really any extra yards. Here they're hitting the hole quickly with confidence, with speed, and if nothing's there, they're trying to make something out of nothing.
Yeah, Thorne's got 30 yards rushing on the ground so far.
Really give credit to the head coach, Terry Holbert, who has done a masterful job. There's Thorne with the first down.
Number 25, Bo Thorne.
The offensive line, too, is looking pretty strong from Miller's court.
Laker first down.
Yeah, the Lakers are playing with confidence, and that's something that you don't get too much of with a 48-game losing streak. This is a good-looking football team. It's a nice story here in northern Fairfield County.
They definitely have a lot of momentum build up going into this game.
Yes, they do. 37. First and 10 at the 37. Butts pitches to Singleton, sweeping around left end. Now he's going to reverse his field and slips and loses a few. Spot him at the 41.
That's
exactly what we're talking about. In past years, he would have run out of bounds or just given up on the play. There, he's trying to cut back and to make something out of nothing. Knights defense did a great job there sniffing that out.
Lost the 3 yards on that play, brings up second and 13 for the Lakers.
Now Mr. Johnson, who's taping the game for the team, now has his knit hat on as if it's 20 below.
Yeah,
it is getting a little chillier up here. High snap.
Waggle.
Throw to Thorne. Cuts back, gets first down inside the 20.
That pass is completed to number 25, Bo Thorne, for a Laker first down. Butts to Thorne, first down Millersport from the Knights 18.
So the ball will be marked at the Knights 18-yard line. Defense will have to hold now with 2:51 to go in the first half. Stay tuned for halftime. We'll have the Millersport marching Lakers for your halftime enjoyment. Ankeny out wide to the right, Singleton in the slot. Give to Thorne, off right guard. Gain of a couple to be second and 8.
Number 25, Bo Thorne, Laker ball carrier. Pick up of a yard on that play, brings up second and 9 for Millersport.
Coming up on the 2 minute mark to go in the first half. Second and 8. Thorne and Moore are the backs. Play action. Ball thrown. Touchdown. Millersport.
Pass is completed in the end zone. The number 5, Corey Jude, for a Laker touchdown. Butts to Jude. 6 points.
Corey
Lakers
Butts
12, night
to
zero.
Jude for the touchdown.
A minute 48 remaining in the first half.
That'll make it 12 to nothing with the point after to follow. Wouldn't be surprised if they try to go for 2. And they will.
Extra point attempt coming up for Millersport.
Butts with Moore. There's a high snap. Butts will keep it. Works to the right side, and he's brought down. Nice play there by Kyle Mosley to stand his ground. So that point after, 2-point conversion fails. And with under 2 minutes to go, 1:48 to be exact, it's Millersport 12, FCA nothing. The FCA Sports Network.
The FCA Sports Network is brought to you by Service Master Clean by Todd George. They provide cleaning services for Fairfield County. They will help you get clean and stay that way at work and at home. Service Master Clean by Todd George is proud to demonstrate their commitment to excellence and their promise to do the job right or do it over. Service Master Clean by Todd George, 740-687-1077.
So we'll see how the Knights do with this kickoff return. Nice kickoff return will give them some good field position for the first time tonight.
Yes. Well, they got a minute and 48 to put some points on the board.
Walls and Lee back in dual safety. Here's the approach. Hit at the 20 through Jeremiah Lee's legs. Picks it up at the 8. Hit and drop at the 5-yard line, maybe the 6.
Ball rolls back.
Dalton Ankeny on the,
in the end zone.
I believe made that play.
Excellent.
Yes, he did. He just laid him out.
Number 22, Dalton Ankeny.
And he's getting up, limping a little bit now. He's his right shoulder is hurting him.
Yeah, he was the same guy that got up slow on the other play earlier.
First and 10 Knights from their own 7.
Boy, I tell you, the way he hit Jeremiah, it's like he shot out of a cannon.
Yeah.
So the Knights start on their own 7-yard line, first and 10. And there's a... Is that a fumble for a touchdown?
Lakers get the ball in the end zone.
I can't tell if that was a touchdown or a safety.
Well, the official called the touchdown. Looks like it was a fumble.
I didn't see a fumble, but I could have been wrong.
And it's a Millersport touchdown on the turnover.
The ref said touchdown. The PA announcer said safety.
6 more points for Millersport on the turnover.
Extra
now.
Point is coming up.
Here's the point after. Good snap, ball down, kick is up, and the kick is no good off to the right.
Mock's extra point attempt is no good. Leaves
140,
the score.
143 to go now in the first half of play. It's 18 to nothing, Millersport over FCA on the FCA Sports Network.
The FCA Sports Network is brought to you by Central Ohio General Surgeons. They are physicians who are ready and willing to perform invasive procedures for the wellness of their patients. At Central Ohio General Surgeons, your appointment includes time for examination and discussion, so please feel free to ask questions at any time. Central Ohio General Surgeons can be contacted at 740-654-6213.
Now the Knights will have Lee and Walds back in dual safety. They'll put Caleb Walds to the bottom of the screen.
Troy McClung Jr. back to kick for the Lakers.
Troy McClung tees it up at the 40. The approach, the kick to Lee, the 21. 25, 30, 40-yard line. First down for the Knights with 1:41 to go in the first half of play. We'll see if the Knights can do anything here with a minute 40 to go. This is the best field position the Knights have
Knights
had
bring the ball
all night.
Out to their own 40. Going to be first and 10 Knights from the 40.
They're going to mark it at the 39-yard line. Mayers on the sweep. Breaks a tackle. He's got a lane. 40, 50, run out of bounds. First down for the Knights. Isaac Payne threw a nice little block to get Isaac off the edge there.
Well, Mayers really got lucky that time. Could have been
number
stopped in the backfield.
He put on the afterburners, I tell you.
Brought down by
kept going to the outside, and when
channel.
He found the lane, he just put it in to drive.
First down, Fairfield Christian from the
so
Lakers
the Knights
49.
Now at the Laker 49. I believe this is the farthest the Knights have reached. There's Nares, bobbles the ball, cuts back, 45, 40, another first down for the Knights. Moving the football. And Isaac Nares is doing his part.
Number 7, Isaac Nares.
And just like that,
player.
He's got 45 yards
stop
rushing.
Once again by number 71, Kyle Channel.
And now we got a timeout. Timeout.
10 Knights.
FCA with 1:21 to go here in the first half of play. Millersport leads the Knights by a score of 18 to nothing on the FCA Sports Network.
The FCA Sports Network is brought to you by Scrambler Murray's on
it's
ED
easy
Road
for you
in
to
Lancaster.
Say that again.
Scrambler Murray's.
What is it?
Scrambler Murray's.
There you go.
It's the place for breakfast, brunch, or lunch. From Craig's.
Lunch or lunch?
Breakfast, brunch, or lunch. Excuse me.
Go ahead.
I've been
don't
there.
If you don't have dinner plans for this coming Monday.
No, I've been there, but I've been there too.
Be sure to head over to BW3's and Heath on 79.
From crepes or paninis, from burgers to salads, they are perfect for lunch breaks, business meetings, private events, or catering. Scrambler Marie's on Edie Road in Lancaster. You'll never walk away hungry.
Caleb, if you make a living speaking, like I do as a minister, a lot of times your mouth doesn't work and you're surprised at what comes out. So don't worry about it.
That one's harder to read than some of the other ones.
First and 10 for the Knights at the 39. Wabenthal throws, and it is intercepted. Moore has it. And he's going to be dropped at the 34-yard line. And we got a penalty, two penalty flags coming in now.
Ankeny and Butts force the quarterback to make that pass.
So we'll see who that's
on. By number four, Clayton Moore, there is a
almost looked like Millersport could have been guilty of a face mask on Caleb Lawmenthal as they got up close to his face mask as they're trying to bring him down. Now the officials will huddle up and see who the penalty is on. Millersport is applauding, so let's see. It's a personal foul. Millersport. So they'll back him up 15. Like the officials didn't know if it was on Millersport or not. Their
personal foul penalty goes against the Lakers.
A little apprehensive in that call. So Millersport will have the ball deep in their own territory.
First and 10. In a first and 10 for the Lakers
with a minute 12 to go.
After that penalty is assessed, Lakers will have first and 10 from their own 19.
Ball's on the 19. Singleton and Moore out wide to the right. Moore now in motion. Butts with the pitch to Cronenbitter. 25, out of bounds.
About number 26-yard line. The Laker ball carrier.
Second and short.
Forced out of bounds by number 7, Isaac Nayers. Gain of 7 on that play. Brings up second and 3
second
for
and
Millersport.
Three. .106 to go.
29 yards on the ground for Cronenbitter. 28 for Caleb Walls.
Cronenbitter again. Penalty flag on the play. He'll have enough for the first down, but we'll see. This will be holding on Millersport. We'll back him up 10 yards from the spot of the foul.
Stop made by
number
8,
Isaac Payne. There's a flag
behind the play.
58.8 seconds to go.
Well, we're calling Isaac Payne's name a bunch. He's got a couple tackles.
Isaac's having a good game. He has really come on this season.
We'll back him up 10 yards from the spot of the foul.
You can see some of these.
Will still be second down.
Younger players just gained confidence for the Knights.
Yeah, Isaac Nayers especially.
Second
yes.
and 16 coming up for
Isaac
the Lakers.
Isaac Payne, Isaac Nayers.
From their 12.
They've just gained confidence. Bobby Leeper has, even though Bobby isn't playing tonight as a sophomore, he has shown some growth as a football player, and the young offensive line and defensive line as well. So hopefully it bodes well for the future for the Knights next year. Bo Thorne on the carry. Brought down by Kyle Mosley. There's another young football player, sophomore.
Number 25, Bo Thorne, the Laker ball carrier.
Clock is running stop with 20 seconds
Kyle
to go.
Mosley.
See if Millersport will run one more play or not.
For the Lakers.
Doesn't look like it. Looks like they are going to
Lakers
be
are
content
let time expire in the first half
to go into the locker room with an 18-point lead.
The score, your
so, at halftime,
Lakers lead it,
your score
18, Knights,
is
zero.
Millersport 18, FCA nothing. Stay tuned for the Millersport Laker Marching Band halftime show under the direction of Noel Harkabus. That's coming up next on the FCA Sports Network.
These waters were woven into the culture of Native American tribes. The descendants of the early Europeans built a business here based on agriculture. And today, this unique destination in the Central Ohio countryside comes to life with stories and memories centuries old. The Fairfield County Historical Parks invites you to amazing Rock Mill. Above the falls of the Hocking River Gorge, here, together, nature and man have created some truly American stories that you'll want to experience with the entire family. Visit us or learn more about Rock Mill and the largest wooden water wheel in the nation at historicalparks.org.
Isn't private. Beware what you share.
Statistics. Thing is, I could have dropped out of school and become one myself, but I didn't because I had people that believed in me. Here's another statistic. 7,000 students drop out every school day. That's one every 26 seconds. It's time that students know that we believe in them.
Inspire a student and share your message of support at boostup.org.
Halftime here at Millersport High School. Jack Davidson, Caleb Yount, and the FCA media team. Millersport has a 18-0 lead over FCA as we'll begin the start of the third quarter. Caleb has some halftime stats for us, so Caleb, take it away.
Well, Millersport is dominating in the stats. They have 195 total yards compared to FCA's 82. But the FCA Knights defense has kept them out of the end zone on multiple possessions. And for passing, Jonah Butts is 5 of 8 and is connected with Moore and Singleton, both with 40 yards, and Thorne for 22 and Jude for 15. And he has two touchdown passes. Cronenbitter has 29 yards on the ground, and Thorne has 38. And FCA is over 3 on passing, and Walls has 28 yards on the ground, and Isaac Nayers has 45 yards. There's been two turnovers for both teams.
This message was brought to you by Prevention Works for a drug-free Fairfield County.
And three penalties on Millersport, but only one on FCA.
Millersport has had an impressive first half. They came in averaging 215 yards a game rushing. You can see how, with Cronenbitter, to get him out into the outside, he's able to find the lane and go.
Yeah, he's small but fast.
And Butts, you know, passing wise, well, he's averaging 51 yards a game in the passing game. He's averaging a 51% completion rate. So, Millersport has done well this season. They've shown why in this game.
Well, it's just over a 50% passing completion. And he's definitely has more than 50 yards in this game so far. So
we get to hear Steve Perry sing Don't Stop Believing here tonight. Of course, he's probably singing it out in San Francisco a little bit later on, as he's a big San Francisco Giant fan, and he leads the AT&T Park in the singing of Don't Stop Believing. So Steve Perry is who you hear in the background. FCA will get the ball to start the third quarter, as Millersport won the toss to begin the game and elected to receive. So FCA has that last drive, they showed some promise. They had the interception with about a minute 40 to go, or a minute 20 to go, and they just stalled. This is senior night at Millersport. And before the game, they honor Dr. James Whetstone, who is retiring as a Millersport physician. And he'll be spending time with his family next season. So Dr. Whetstone is honored with a game ball before the game and a nice ovation from the Millersport fans. So FCA heads out to start this third quarter with their receiving unit, Caleb Walds and Jeremiah Lee, back deep to receive. And Millersport is about ready to send their kickoff unit on the field.
Number 99, for all his hard work.
Coming into the game, Mid-State League Cardinal Division, Harvest Prep Lakers had a 5-0 record this season. Grove City Christian was at 3-1. Millersport at 3-2 in third place. Fisher Catholic at 2-2. Burn Union at 1-3. FCA at 1-3. And Worthington Christian at 0-4. Last game of the season next week in New Lex. It'll be senior night for the FCA Knights as they take on the crosstown rival, Fisher Catholic. Ball's in the air or underway. Ball tipped to Lee. Hits the 35 to the 37, maybe to the 38. And the Knights start with good field position here to start the third quarter.
Knights bring the ball out to.
So how'd you do in cross country last week?
First and 10, Fairfield.
Well, due to some unfortunate events, I didn't run as well as I would have liked, but it was nothing I could have done. There were too many people in that race, and the temperature was bad. And
Caleb Walls gets the carry. Short of the 38, 39-yard line. Mark it at the 39. It'll be second and say nine. So how'd the team do?
Oh, we did well. We're going on to regionals tomorrow.
And that's in Pickerington, you said?
Yes, Pickerington North.
And that's a track that you know well? You've run there before?
We've ran there before, and they practiced there this afternoon.
Oh, very good. Did you run?
No, I didn't.
Pitch to Nares. Takes the corner, cuts up to the 50-yard line, across the 50, first down. Nice little misdirection play by the Knights.
Number 7, Isaac Nares, the ball carrier for the Knights.
Isaac came out late for football, and they're discovering he's a nice little playmaker. He's had some nice runs in that first half.
Moves it into Laker territory. Going to be first and 10
for
the Knights.
So first and 10 for the Knights at the Laker 49. Jeremiah Lee, the quarterback, gives it to Caleb Walds, and he is going to reach the 45-yard line, then be pushed back.
Caleb Walls.
So it looks like they're going to put Jeremiah Lee at quarterback and have Isaac Nares take that wingback position that Jeremiah was playing in place of Bobby Leeper.
Tackle made by number 71, Kyle Channel. Pick up a 5 yards.
So it'll be second and 5 for the Knights at the 45. As a score gets them back into this thing. Plenty of football left with 10:25 to go in the third quarter. Payne in motion. And we got a penalty flag. And it will be legal motion on the Knights.
Dead ball foul. Full start penalty goes against the Knights.
I'll back them up 5. And they'll mark the ball at the 50. It'll be second.
That'll back them up 5 yards. Going to be second down, 11 to go for the Knights.
That's only the second penalty on the Knights this game.
Nares in motion, and another flag, and another penalty, this time on the Lakers.
Looks like the Lakers move first that time. Knights get their 5 yards back. Still second down.
That's Miller
Sports. The ball. Go ahead.
That's Miller Sports' fourth penalty tonight.
Now they're marking the ball at the 45. This is what I don't get. They have to go to a little inside the 40. So this brings up second and 5. I don't get how they mark the yardage off. I know they're supposed to mark off 5 yards, but it looked like
no gain on the play.
They marked off 6 on both penalties.
6 go for Fairfield Christian.
So it's 3rd and 6.
I think the chainsmen are off a little bit.
I think so.
Big third down stop coming up.
Third down.
Let them hear you, fans.
We're
going
to call it 3rd and 5 because that's what it looks like from here. Payne in motion. Give to Caleb Walds, who looks like he has enough for the first down.
Well, they kept pushing forward and
now they're going to mark him at
number
the 40, so let's see where it looks like they're, it looks to me like they, the way they mark it, they should measure it.
I think he got the first down.
Just shy of the first down, brings up 4th and inches for
but
the
but they're going to say 4th and inches.
But they have the ball spotted ahead of the chain on the one side.
I know, that's what I was talking about. My 58-year-old eyes didn't deceive me, did they?
No, they didn't.
And now we got a timeout.
Because that's a first
and
down.
Now they're going to ask for a measurement.
Official timeout on the field.
If it isn't, it's like 1/2 inch and we should run away.
I figured that they should have at least measured it before the play because That is awful close to a first down. If it's not first down, it's fourth and inches. That is just right across from where our broadcast position is. They're just going to play fourth down now. Give to Caleb Walls. He's got a first down there. Yeah, the spotting of the ball in that series was, I think, questionable. On the penalties and also on that fourth down play. And we're just trying to be honest. Well, Knight's first down at the 37. Lee back to pass. Looks, throws long. It is incomplete, intended for Isaac Payne.
Pass intended for number 83, Isaac Payne, falls incomplete.
We'll bring up second down.
Clayton Moore on the coverage.
Good coverage on the play by number 4, Clayton Moore. Brings up
now you may wonder why they passed the ball, seeing as they were running so effectively. It just kind of keeps the defense
50,
honest.
50 tickets out.
Now they got to at least think pass. Lee rolls left, throws incomplete off of Caleb Walls' hand.
I'm going to bring up
third down.
Brings up third and 10 for the Knights. 50-50 number. Get your tickets out, folks. Number 1596423.
So did you win the 50-50?
I didn't enter.
You didn't enter, okay. I didn't either.
Pick up your
I didn't even know they were doing it.
American.
Fumble. Lee throws incomplete. Tended receiver.
Just off Walls' hands again.
Caleb
Walls.
Number 32, Caleb Walls falls incomplete.
So I'll bring up fourth down.
And 10 for the Knights.
And we'll see what the Knights decide to do here.
Once again, if you missed it, 50-50 ticket number 1596423.
Looks like they'll go for it.
Come to the press box for your $191 in winnings.
Lee back to pass. Looks, throws. He's got a receiver. It is, I think, Isaac Nears will be. No, it's Caleb Lobenthal will be short of the first down. So the Knights will turn the ball over on downs.
14, Caleb Lobenthal. They don't pick up the yardage necessary.
Millersport takes over.
First
and 10 now with 7:21 to go in the third quarter of play. First possession for Millersport in this second half. Butts over center. Thorne heads up the middle, hit by Lobenthal, Payne, and let's see, who else? Gerken in there and Waltz as well.
Pick up of a yard on that play.
Be second and nine.
For Millersport.
Coming up on the 7-minute mark here, third quarter play. I want to remind you, next week, come to you from New Lex, the crosstown rivals, Fisher Catholic and FCA, final game of the season for both teams. Join us. If not, we'll have it on the LSN TV and the FCA Sports Network. Butts to Cronenbitter. Hits the 30, and he's driven out of bounds. Good play there by Isaac Nears. He lowered his shoulder. And I wonder if Cronenbitter got to the line of scrimmage. He might have lost a yard there.
Number 83, Isaac
Payne. Bring up third and 10.
Yard on that play, brings
it was back to the original line of scrimmage. Third and 10. Butts. Play action. Throws long, wide open. Singleton has it. 40, 35 inside the 35. to the 30-yard line. Make it to 31. First down for Millersport.
Butts to Singleton for a Laker first down.
It's a 40-yard pass.
First and 10, Millersport. And
Singleton was wide open. Butts pitches to Cronenbitter. 30, 25, 20. Knocked out of bounds.
Number two, Brandon Cronenbitter.
First down for the Lakers.
Forced out of bounds by number four, Jeremiah Lee, but not before. I'll
tell you, Cronenbitter finds that hole. He hits it quick, and he's fast, and he's through it in the blink of an eye.
First and 10, Millersport from the Knights 14.
So first and 10 at the 14-yard line of the Knights as Millersport is driving. Singleton and Moore out wide to the right. Thorne now moves to a slot in the right. Pitch to Cronenbitter. Looking for a lane. Cuts up. He's got a first down inside the 5-yard line.
Number two,
you mark him right at the five.
Picks up another Laker.
And that's a first down for Millersport.
Well, the Knights defense really needs to stop here. They're down by a couple scores.
And Lakers from the Knights two.
Millersport in command, and they're driving. First and goal. They mark it at the. Looks like it's at the 2-yard line. Cronenbitter cuts up.
Handoff goes to number two, Brandon Cronenbitter.
Maybe a half yard on the play. Bring up second and goal.
I don't think they even give him a half a yard.
Picked up a half a yard on the play, brings up second and goal from the two.
PA announcer says you're right, but
it's because we're probably the same age and we have old eyes. I go with you. Pitch to Cronenbitter. Flag on the play as Cronenbitter goes into the end zone.
Pitch goes to number two, Brandon Cronenbitter, who takes it in for a Laker touchdown.
Let's see what the penalty flag is on.
There is a flag behind the play.
It might be holding.
Well, the ref who threw the flag did not signal touchdown, but the ref opposite to him did.
Holding on Millersport.
Holding penalty goes against the
official
who
threw that had a good arm. I'll back him up 10 from the spot of the foul. And it'll be second and goal.
It's going to back him up 10 yards from the spot of the foul.
And let's see, they mark it at the 11.
Five penalties for Millersport on the night. And it's hurting them here right now.
Motion, sprint out, sprint out.
Cronenbitter, Wald's in pursuit. And Cronenbitter gets across the 10-yard line.
Number two, BK, the ball carrier.
Logan Rocha on the stop.
Gain of 3 yards on the play. Brings up third and goal for the Lakers.
Third
from
and goal at the 8. Actually, they'll mark it at the 9. So gain of a couple. It's gotten conceivably colder here in the second half. Temperature has dropped. Probably in the low 50s right now. There's a backdoor pass to Cronenbitter, who scoots into the end zone for a touchdown for the Lakers. Cronenbitter on that touchdown pass from Butts.
Millersport leads at 24.
And it's now a 24-0 lead over FCA with 4:02 to go. In the third quarter of play, we've got the point after to follow.
last Sunday.
Low snap, ball down, kick is up, and the kick is good.
Matt Murphy kicks
4:02 to go, third quarter of play. 25-0 Millersport over FCA on the FCA Sports Network.
Kick off your Christmas season with the 2014 Joy Tour with Stephen Curtis Chapman and Brandon Heath. Stephen Curtis Chapman is the most awarded Christian artist in...
Don't forget, folks...
Most awarded artist in Christian music with 58 Gospel Music Association Dove Awards, 5 Grammys, and 47 number one singles, and approaching 11 million albums sold. The Joy Tour hits Lancaster, Ohio at the Fairfield Christian Church on Saturday, December 6th at 6 p.m. Ticket information at 740-654-0099 or online at rushconcerts.com.
Lakers will kick it to the Knights.
Redeemer Lutheran Church and Dr. Jack Davidson have served the Lancaster area for over 30 years. Located at 1400 Concordia Drive in Lancaster with Sunday service at 10:15. You can also hear the Redeemer Reflections radio program with Dr. Jack Davidson every Monday morning at 4:30 and on WFCO 90.9.
Here's the kick, short kick. Fielded by the Knights. At the 40, we got a fumble at the 30, and we'll see who comes up with it.
Ball squirted loose twice on the play.
Jeremiah Lee signals the Knights have it.
All right, so the Knights will take over.
Looks like the Knights managed to fall on it. It's going to be
looks
first
like
and 10.
They'll mark it at their own 30-yard line.
From their own 30-yard line.
So first and 10 for the Knights. Under 4 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Knights down 25-0. Jeremiah Lee leads the troops out of the huddle. Nares and Payne, the wing backs. There's a keeper by Lee across the 30, maybe to the 31. I don't know if that was a broken play or not. Gain of a couple, it'll be second and 8.
Number 4, Jeremiah Lee, the Knights ball carrier. Pick up a 3 on that play, brings up second and 7 for the Knights.
Well, with our angle, it could have been a fumbled snap, and we might not have seen it.
And penalty flag. Oh, it's a timeout for the Knights. Timeout on the field with 3:20 to go, third quarter play. The Knights down by a score 25-0 to Millersport on the FCA Sports Network.
Fairfield Christian Church, serving Lancaster at the corner of Columbus and Whittier Streets near the River Valley Mall. Pastor Trevor Littleton invites you to know Christ, grow in Him, and share His love. Sunday morning services at 9 and 10:45. Learn more online at fairfieldchristian.org. Have you ever packed a shoebox for Operation Christmas Child? You can pick up empty boxes and return them packed to Fairfield Christian Church. Drop-off deadline is Monday, November 17th. Learn more how you can change a life this Christmas with a shoebox at SamaritansPurse.org.
Knights come out of this timeout. Second.
Second and coming up for
8.
The Knights.
Nares in motion. Pitch to Isaac Nares. 30. 35. Cut down at the 40 to the 41. It should be enough for a first down.
Pitch goes to number 7 for the Knights. Isaac Nares. Stop made by number 3, Storm Singleton.
Tell you, Isaac Nares is a good-looking running back.
First down yardage on the play. First
kind of like Cronenbitter for Millersport. You get him out in space. He's got this speed to get around the edge. Gain some yards. Lobenthal out wide to the left. Nares in motion and penalty.
Well, Nares is having a breakout game. He's got 62 yards in the ground.
False start penalty goes
false
against
start
the Knights.
On the Knights.
Still back him up 5. It'll still be first down. First
looks like that's what the Knights are just trying to do. Get Isaac
36.
In some space and use his speed.
Walls only has 41 yards rushing.
Sometimes it's just that simple. As you get the ball to your playmakers and let them make plays. Caleb Walls and Jeremiah Lee. Bobby Leeper, they've been the playmakers for the night so far. There's a pitch to Nairs. That's a fumble. And the Lakers say they have it, and they do.
That incomplete reverse pass is ruled a fumble. Lakers recover.
So the Lakers get the ball back in great field position with 2:32 to go. And the Knights need to hold. If not,
Millersport
scores, we're in a running clock situation. Clock will run continuously if one team is ahead by 30 points or more in the second half. Millersport is 5 points away from that, so the Knights want to hold. First and 10. Play action. Pass. Singleton. Got it. Touchdown. 33-yard pass. Butts to Singleton. 31-0 with a point after to follow.
Makes the score Lakers 31, Knights 0. Extra point attempt coming up.
And Millersport is reveling in this because there have been plenty of seasons where the Knights have had their number. This is payback for Millersport. So the point after to follow, 31-0. 2:35 to go. There's a botched snap. Moore has it. And it'll be tackled short of the goal line. So that PAT will fail. That's the third time that they have not converted on a point after this game. So we're in a running clock situation with 2:25 to go here in the third quarter play. Millersport leads by a score of 31-0 on the FCA Sports Network.
Normal clock operations will resume. Thank you for
you can keep up with Sheriff
game.
Dave Phelan on Go This Lakers. Week with Sheriff Dave Phelan on LSN TV, Lancaster Time Warner Channel 9. He interviews great guests and shares important community information. Mondays at 11 a.m. and 4 p.m. Tuesdays at 12 noon and 9 p.m. on LSN Lancaster Community TV. Available 24/7 online at lancasterohio.tv. Well, the Knights have three turnovers, two fumbles and one interception, and two of them had led to touchdowns.
Knights to receive the ball. They've had their moments. There's an onside kick or short kick that goes out of bounds. So the Knights will get the ball in good field position.
Kick rolls out of bounds, results in.
I don't know if that's an onside kick or if he shanked it.
No return.
So now we're in a running clock situation. As the clock is running at 2:05 and counting, the Knights score a touchdown or even kick a field goal here. Then we're back to where they'll be stopping the clock. But right now, the clock will run continuously. And the Knights break the huddle. First and 10 at their own 38. Give to Caleb Walds. Hits the hole. He'll be shy of the 45-yard line. Looks like he'll mark him at the 44. Good gain for Caleb, but on first down, he'll bring up second and four.
For the Knights.
At 110 and counting here in the third quarter.
Defense,
Nears in motion, gives to Isaac. He's going to try to gain the corner, and he's cut down by Singleton for
number
a loss
seven,
on
Isaac
the play.
Nears, the Knights ball carrier.
And now Isaac Nears is down and injured. Dr. Whetstone, the medical staff, is on the field. Looks like they're trying to stretch Isaac out. Maybe he just has a cramp.
That's all it looked like to me.
Let's hope that's all it is. So the players take a knee. Allows us to let you know this is the FCA Sports Network. Watch us on LSN TV, Lancaster Time Warner Channel 9, or on YouTube on LancasterOhio.tv. You'll learn more about Lancaster, Ohio on a weekly conversation called Lancaster Perspective with Mike Miller. Mike adds perspective on Lancaster, Ohio business, Lancaster, Ohio events, Lancaster, Ohio hidden treasures. That's Lancaster Perspective with Mike Miller. It's informative and engaging on LSN TV, Lancaster Time Warner Channel 9, Monday and Tuesdays at 10 a.m. and 5:30 p.m. Available 24/7 online at LancasterOhio.tv. As Isaac Mayers walks off under his own power, it's good to see. I want to remind you, too, that today's broadcast is a high school production of the high school media team at FCA. Students announcing, students on camera, students producing, and mixing. Thank the students for all their hard work. You won't believe the hard work that they put in to get here early to set up and then to tear down. They do a fine job, and they're honored, and we are honored to bring this to you. We want to thank you for listening and supporting the FCA Sports Network. Bring you the game next week, and then we'll take a little break and get ready for basketball season. And basketball is always fun as football
after
is,
that
too.
Loss of a yard brings up third and 11 for the Knights.
So third and 11 for the Knights. Clock is running at 33 seconds. Lee back to pass. Now he's going to tuck it and run to the 40, 45-yard line. Clock is running with 19 seconds to go.
Number four, Jeremiah Lee, the ball carrier.
And that
tackle
will
by number three, Storm Singleton.
Do it, I believe, for the third quarter of play as we're at 8 seconds.
Gain of eight on that play.
Seven,
up fourth
six,
and three for
five,
the
four, three, two, one. And we've got 12 more minutes remaining in
that
the game. Millersport leads the Knights by a score of 31-0 on the FCA
zero.
Sports Network.
When you throw away money on wasted electricity, you're throwing away everything you could have bought with it. Saving energy saves you money. Learn more at energysavers.gov.
Start of the fourth quarter here. Caleb will bring you some stats that he's been keeping.
Let's hear it again for those senior
cheerleaders. Isaac Nayers has 57 yards to the ground after losing some with his loss. Caleb Walls with 47
Anderson,
yards,
Michaela
and Lee Hayden, with 20 yards.
Jesse Kirk, and Allie Schilling.
That's for FCA. For Millersport, Cronin Bitter has 49 yards on the ground. Moore has 8 yards. Thorne has 39 yards. And Singleton has 3. But Singleton has 110 yards receiving and one touchdown.
So FCA will start the fourth quarter. It'll be fourth and four at the 45-yard line. We'll say fourth and three. They have to get to the 48, their own 48 for the first down.
Fourth and three coming up for them.
And we're in a running clock situation. So as soon as they snap the ball, now the clock runs. Lee tucks and runs, hit at the 46, and the Knights will turn the ball over on downs. Millersport holds. So we'll see what Millersport does here with 11:35 to go.
Millersport playing excellent defense that time.
Turnover on downs. First and 10 coming up for the Lakers from the Fairfield Christian 47.
Butts the quarterback. Now he goes under center. Give to Cronenbitter, who's hit in the backfield and dropped by Caleb Waltz. Loss on the play. They'll mark it at the 49. Loss of two, maybe three. It'll be second and long.
Caleb Waltz. Loss of 2 yards on that play. Brings up second and 12 for Millersport.
I want to remind you to join us next Friday night. You have nothing to do, come out to New Lex to see the crosstown rivals, the Irish against the Knights, the final home football game for the Knights in the season. High snap, Butts loses it, and let's see, I think the Knights have it. So scrum at the bottom. Now they're going to say that Millersport came up with it. They'll bring up third and long.
Lakers managed to fall on it.
Like the Knights were in there to grab it, but that loose pig skin got away.
Brings up third and 22 for the Lakers.
So third and 22 for Millersport. Under normal circumstances, be a passing situation, but we'll see what they do here. Up by 31 and a running clock. Looks like they're in a passing formation. Three wide receivers to the right, one to the left. Throw, complete. Flurg on the catch.
Butts' pass is completed. Number nine, Tyler McClung.
And that'll bring up a fourth and 10 situation for Millersport. Gain of 12 on the play. Let's see if Millersport punts the ball away. It looks like they will. Bo Thorne will kick it away. He stands at his own 42-yard line. Leon Lobenthal back in dual safety for the Knights. High snap. Thorne picks it up. Now he's going to throw it. He's got Moore open. Catches. First down. 30. Inside to 30 to the 28.
That muck pass is completed to number four, Clayton Moore.
So that was not a, that wasn't a punt. That just looked like it was a set play.
That's muck.
That was a punt. I think Thorne would have kicked the ball away. He had plenty of time, but he looked to pass it.
Fake punt results in a first down, Millersport.
So the fake punt works for Millersport as they try to pour salt in the wound. The FCA.
First and 10 Lakers from the Knights 28.
First and 10 at 28. Pitch to Cronenbitter. Scoots up.
Number two, BK, the Laker ball
to the 25-yard line. Gain of 3, second and 7. Clock is running at 7:45 to go
pick
in the ball
the
game.
Pick up the 3 on that carry. Brings up second and 7 for the Lakers.
Cronenbitter just can't seem to break 50 yards in the ground. He gets right up there. And then he'll get stopped in the backfield. And currently he's at 49.
Well, bite your tongue. You may get the ball here. No, it's Thorne. Across the 25 to the 24.
Number 25, Bo Thorne.
Yeah, you just wonder where Cronenbitter's going to break one, you know? That's why I said bite your tongue, because I expect him to get the ball here in one of these two downs.
It always seems like I have bad luck too, so.
I'm
Third down, third and six with 6:53 to go in the ball game. Kronenbitter and Thorne in the backfield. Kronenbitter is the deep back play action. Butts tucks it, 20, 15, to
number
about 13, the 11-yard line.
Butts calls his own number
Jeremiah
one.
Lee on the stop.
Yardage picked up for a Millersport first down.
Millersport moving the ball.
First and 10 Lakers from the Knights 11.
First and 10 at the 11. Looks like Thorne gets the carry. Might give him forward progress to the line of scrimmage.
Number 57, Chase Hatfield, the Laker ball carrier.
Chase Hatfield on the carry.
No gain on
check
the play.
That
brings up second and 10 for the Lakers.
Looks like Hatfield gets the ball again. Met at the line of scrimmage. It'll bring up third down.
Number 64, Troy McClung Jr., the Laker ball carrier.
McClung.
Loss of 1 yard on that play. Brings up third and 11 for the Lakers.
Looking at Millersport's schedule, this is their final game of the season. They don't have a game, at least in their program, they don't have a game scheduled next week. There's a pass touchdown
to
Clayton Moore.
Number four, Clayton Moore for the Lakers touchdown. Completion.
Six more points on the board, makes it 37-0 with a point after the follow.
Makes the score Lakers 37, Knights 0.
So Millersport will go to 7-2 on the season. And playing nine games, if they're only playing nine games, I'm not sure if they have a game added or not. They're going to need some help getting the playoffs. This is a fine-looking football team, though, and they're putting it onto the Knights by a score of 37-0. Snap ball down, line drive kick is no good.
Matt Murphy's kick.
Well, we didn't expect either team to take to the air as much as they did. Millersport is 11 for 14 and pretty effective through the air.
They've been effective all night. So, the FCA Sports Network brought to you by
Big Sandy Superstore and Service Master Clean by Todd George, Central Ohio General Surgeons, Scrambler Murray's, the 2014 Joy Tour, Operation Christmas Child, Redeemer Lutheran Church, and Dr. Jack Davidson, Fairfield Christian Church. This week with Sheriff Dave Phelan and Lancaster Perspective with Mike Miller.
Millersport honoring their seniors a final time as they give a round of applause to the seniors in their final home game of the season. I want to thank you for joining us on the FCA Sports Network. One more game next week at New Lex. Ball teed up at the 40. With 4:39 to go in the ball game.
Troy McClung Jr. gets
Troy
the ball teed
McClung
up just the way he likes it.
Will make the approach, and here's the kick, short kick. And we have a penalty flag and offside on Millersport. I'll back him up 5 yards.
Lakers got a little ahead of the kicker. False start penalty against Millersport.
So they're going to keep the clock running at 4:18 and counting. So run some more time off
five.
The clock.
McClung will kick from the 35.
So Knights will get the ball back under 4 minutes to go and probably will start their offense at around 3 minutes to go.
Back to receive for the Knights number 32, Caleb Walls, and number 4,
the Millersport
Jeremiah
fans are getting into it because a press box up here is shaking. There's a onside kick fielded by Millersport.
Storm Singleton falls on that kick.
Storm Singleton on the recovery.
Millersport retains possession.
Man,
first and 10,
Singleton
Lakers.
is he's all over
from the
field. He's
40. Number 3, Storm Singleton on that recovery.
Wow. I'm speechless. He's just recovered that kick. He's got 110 yards receiving. He's got some rushing. He's got a touchdown. He's done everything. Actually, I wouldn't say everything because they've done a great job spreading the ball around.
No, he's not doing the announcing tonight, but he's having a good game.
Millersport has spread the ball around really well. It's been making stat keeping pretty hard.
But you've done a fine job.
Thank you.
First and 10 at the 40. 2:40 to go in the ball game. Give to Thorne off right end. Gain of two, maybe
number
three.
Number 25, Bo Thorne on the carry for the Lakers.
Bring up second.
Up
we'll say second and
play.
Eight.
Brings up second and eight for Millersport.
Caleb Walls busted through the line and grabbed his ankle. Well, Thorns is slowly closing in on Cronenbitter with rushing yards this game.
Thorne gets the carry again.
Number 25, Bo Thorne
Gain
carries for the Lakers.
Of maybe one. Now we have a timeout. Millersport.
22 yards on that play. Brings up third and six for Millersport. Timeout, Lakers.
As the Millersport
by the way, seniors and parents
takes
of
a timeout. Now they're going
to
bring the seniors out. And they'll get a nice
fence.
Round of applause here on Senior Night. Child. It allows us to let you know that this is the FCA
tonight,
Sports Network.
Take the banner down.
Fairfield Media is honored to present the FCA Sports Network,
tonight.
Where the FCA Knights accept the challenge to represent Fairfield Christian Academy in an
with just under 2 minutes left in the contest.
Oh, I think this is the one you want.
Yeah, this is what I thought I was going to be reading, but it wasn't. Well, our camera for today was manned by Caleb Peters, Connor Harrison, Emily Green, and Ian Parrish. We got Sam Herdman, Abby Nielsen, and Harrison Poole out there in the back. And JT Burcham, the director, and me and you, Jack, up here in the booth, as always, announcing.
So we want to thank the students and JT for working so hard behind the scenes to make us sound good and to bring you the game. As we are about 90 seconds to go in this football game. Millersport will go to 7-2 on the season, and FCA will fall to 1-8.
And there they go again, running it to a freshman, and I have to write another guy down in the stat paper.
Singleton. Still moving. And he's driven out of bounds.
That handoff goes to number 3, Storm Singleton.
Storm Singleton. It's like a water bug out there.
And then picks up the first down.
Logan Rocha gets
Lakers.
Up limping. 51 seconds to go, so Millersport can run one more play.
First and 10, Millersport from the Knights 26.
Now they stop the clock with 51.3 seconds to go. Now they'll start it. Now there's a timeout. As we wait for the Knights to get one more player on. .9 seconds, and Millersport will be in the victory formation.
Lakers line up in the victory formation.
There's the knee.
Well, the Knights finished this game with 130 total yards. Most of that was on the ground. Only 5 was through the air.
So one more play to go here with 24 seconds to go. Millersport will take a knee. And they'll get to ring the victory bell one more time. They're not going to stop the clock. They're just going to let it run out. And Millersport is victorious. Beat the Knights by a score of 37-0. So for the FCA media team and Caleb Young, this is Jack Davidson thanking you for watching FCA Sports on the FCA Sports Network. For this time, till next time, have a good night, everybody.
Preventing wildfires. That's all Smokey wants for his 70th birthday.